Hey guys, Eric Bowman. We're back here at the Patient Care Tower. We are currently in the fixtures part of it. We're doing all of our finishes. That includes putting fixtures up on the walls. It includes medical gas panels on walls. It includes equipment hookups down in the basement is where we're gonna be heading first. So we're down in the mechanical room now. This is where a lot of our equipment is. As you can see here, this is our domestic water booster pumps. So water comes into the building from the city. We go through a set of backflows. We lose a little bit of pressure. We come in, water comes in, goes into these pump systems. These are set to certain pressures because we need to be able to send water all the way up to the penthouse of this building. So as we send water through here out to the building, we're also sending water up and into the instant hot water tanks. So water comes through, goes through a check valve, comes down in, water feeds in, goes out, and this is where we're sending water, not right out to the building yet. Out of here, we go over to the mixing valves. So the hot water line is gonna shoot across the ceiling of this room. Now here, what we have is we actually have a cold water line ran over, cold water, hot water come in, they tie together at a set point. Then water now goes out to the building at a certain temperature to all of the rooms. This here is one of the mixing valve skids that we do. This was actually prefabbed in our shop. We strategically take certain things apart, whether it's unions, certain joints we won't press so that we can label, take things apart, set it out in the field, bolt them on the wall, and then go ahead and reconnect just like a puzzle. A lot of work like this, I will say, can't be done without our fab shop foreman, Joe Kirby. People don't see that he does all this. You know, he fabricates this, he communicates with us out in the field, and we make it so that we can handle it out here, you get it out here, so it's a quick, fast, and easy installation. So these right here, these are our medical gas skid. May look kind of weird, but there's two different skids here. This one here is a medical vacuum. So out of all the patient rooms throughout the building, their medical vacuum all comes back to this unit here. And this one here, this is medical air. So this is sending out medical air to all of the patient rooms, all 64 rooms, MRI, the inpatient holding, all gets sent out to there. The other medical gas that we have throughout the building is oxygen. We don't have anything in here for oxygen. There's actually a tank farm on the other side of the building that we run through the hospital and brought in through here, and it just ties into one of the lines that we had ran. So that's actually work completed on another part of the project. One thing to remember with all of this medical gas stuff is this is something that our plumbing licenses do not cover. This is a completely different certification that our manpower goes through a certain class, 40-hour class, and actually gets tested to be able to perform this work. So here on the second floor and the third floor, we're starting to get into the finish stages. So as you can see, drywall is going up. You go into the bathrooms, we've got tile going up. This is one of 32 patient care rooms. Every room is equipped with a toilet, a sink, and medical gases, which are supplied by the plumbing contract. As you can see, every color represents something different from medical gas. Green and white is oxygen, black and yellow is medical air, and black and white is vacuum. These here, these are slides. So if they need to bring in portable oxygen or anything like that, they bring it in, they slide it right on, lands on this clip, won't fall out. So up above us is our, obviously the overhead work, where not so much on this floor, on third floor we can show you. You'll see some sanitary sewers going through, vents going through, storm sewers going through. Most of them are already insulated and labeled, ready to go. Here, we don't have any ceiling grid up yet, so we're still able to see everything, but each room gets its own tempered water line for their dialysis boxes. Each room gets a hot line for their sink. Each room gets a cold line to their sink and their toilet.
I'm Garrett O'Brien. I'm now a second year apprentice with the Wm.T.Spaeder company. I was lucky enough to come to this project at the beginning stages as a first year. I started, and when I got here, we were doing bangets and initial layout. Through that process, I was able to move forward and work with a journeyman to start running all the water mains, all the way from our booster pumps up through the building. Being able to see how that layout of bangets helps us with prefab and getting things here with racks, and helps us run faster and more efficiently, and make sure that
there's less field failures or mistakes or anything we have to fix in the field that would potentially waste time.
So initially I started my construction career as a laborer. Working beside Wm.T.Spaeder at the Erie Insurance Project, I got to see how they implemented their field work and prefab, and I was extremely intrigued by it. Being able to work for Spaeder gave me the opportunity to actually step in as a plumber and figure out what all was going on. It gave me a chance to think outside the box and step outside of my comfort zone. Being able to work for Spaeder is awesome. I've been paired up with great foremen, Eric Bowman and my journeymen, and they're not afraid to answer any of the questions they may have. I came in as a first year not knowing the first thing about plumbing. Being able to come in and have somebody that answers the questions, explains to me mechanically why it's happening that way is perfect for me because that's how I think. Different from a residential setting, which I've always done here and there, but being on a giant project and seeing everything come together, now we have painted walls and cabinets coming from just mezzanine and steel, or when I was initially here, it was just a giant hole in the ground. It's crazy to think in that short amount of time everything we've pulled together and how we've worked as a team to get it through and get it done. And now we're getting ready to button it up. And it's just, it kind of gives you a sense of pride when you go home to look behind you and see what you've done throughout the years. Right now I'm putting on service stops so we can get our sinks in. It's just one of our last steps before we start finishing everything up. Get a service stop on so we can supply the water to the sinks. After that, I'll be putting traps on so we have our drainage and then go from there. Test it, make sure everything works again and no leaks and we're all good.
Hey guys, thanks for watching our Patient Care Tower series. As you can see, we're wrapping up, so hopefully we'll see you on the next one. And don't forget to watch all the other videos and seeing what we do in all the other departments.